Good morning, children. Today, before we begin, let us pray once and ask blessings from God. Okay, children. We have already studied in the previous chapter about parts of speech. Which are the parts of the speech, children? Do you remember? Yes, that is noun, pronoun, verb, adverb, adjective, etc. So today, in chapter 10, we will have to learn verbs. Let's look at these examples. First example is, the girl brushes her teeth. What is this girl doing? She brushes her teeth. And also look at this picture. In this picture, you can see these children fly kites. So, who are these children? These children are nouns. And the object is kites. Okay, what are these children doing? They are flying kites. The children fly kites. The verb is fly. The children, it is noun. Verbs tell us what a noun is doing. So here what is noun? The children. Here what is noun? The girl. Action, brushes. Here the action is fly. Action verbs are verbs that tell us about a particular action done by a noun. Have you understood the children? This, what are verbs? Once again I repeat, verbs tell us about what a noun is doing. So what is this noun doing? The girl, girl is the noun. What does this girl do? The girl does brushes. The girl brushes her teeth. What does these children doing? These children fly kites. Okay? Now, let us see what are auxiliary verbs. Auxiliary verbs are helping verbs that are used with an action word or main verb. Sometimes we use these words as auxiliary verbs, sometimes we use as main verb. They are often used to show the tense of the verb and does not carry a meaning of its own. Let us see the examples. Rina has a frock. So here has is the main verb. This auxiliary verb is used as a main verb. Next example, Rina has brought a pen. So here the main verb is brought and auxiliary verb is has. So this shows one tense. I have given you, they are often used to show the tense of the verb. So what tense? You will learn it. What tense it is? Actually, this is present perfect tense. What tense it is? Present perfect tense. So, you know what are auxiliary verbs. Let us see, there are two kinds of verbs we can see here. First one is transitive verb, another one is intransitive verb. So, let us see what is transitive verb. A transitive verb, that is a verb that needs an object. A verb that needs an object. So this sentence we need object there. Let us see what is the object here. The boys fly kites. So which is the object? This is the object. Verb is fly. So this is verb and kites are object. Okay. Next example. The man cut a tree. So here the object is tree. This is object. And cut verb. So that is why this sentence, these verbs are called transitive verbs. Next we have Manisha sang a song. So which is the object? Song. Song is the object. Sang is verb. So this sentence, you have object and this verb is called transitive verb. Once again I repeat, transitive verbs are verbs that need an object to express a complete thought. The meaning of the verbs will remain incomplete without their objects. So without their object, the meaning of the sentence will be incomplete. Okay, children? This, what is it? Now, is it clear, children? These sentences, verbs are having object. So, we need to say these verbs are transitive verbs. So, this needs object. Now, let us take the other example, that is intransitive verbs. So, here, what is the verb? Rajiv ran fast. Rajiv ran fast. Is there any object here? No object. Which is the verb? Ran is the verb. Next sentence you can see. The sun rises in the east. So here we don't find any object. The sun rises. What? You cannot say. The rises is the verb. So this sentence is complete without an object. So here this sentence we don't need any object. So the sentence is complete. The baby cries. The baby cries is also a full sentence. So which is the verb here? Cries. Cries is the verb and there is no object. So this kind of sentences we call it intransitive. This verb is called intransitive verb. So intransitive verbs are verbs that have no object. A sentence with an intransitive verb is complete and does not need an object. Okay, children, have you understood this much? Now we have one more part, that is incomplete verbs. Incomplete verb that does not make any sense by itself. So let us see which are the incomplete verbs. The girl seems. The girl seems. What is this? It's an incomplete verb. Saurav looks. This sentence is also incomplete. So we need to add something to make it complete this. So we can add the girl seems happy. Okay, we can add the girl seems happy. Here another example. Saurav looks smart. It can be Saurav looks sad. Saurav looks smart. So these are the different words we can add to make it complete. So these are incomplete verbs, and when you add something to some words to these verbs, then it is complete. So these are called like happy, smart. These words we call it complements. These are the complements of the verbs. Complements of the verbs. Okay, children, now three parts we have gone through. So now we will have the exercise in page 39. Now let us discuss the exercise A, underline the action words. Here, number one, the bird sang sweetly. So which is a noun here? The bird. What action the bird do? The bird sang. Underline the action word. Which is the action word? Sang. She ran towards the door in a hurry. Who ran? She ran. So ran is the action word. The boy sat quietly with folded arms. What did the boy do here? The boy sat quietly with folded arms. So three I have done with for you, and next the rest of the number you can do it yourself. Number 4 to 10 you will do it in your book. Similarly, we have exercise B in your grammar book, page 39. All of you look at the page 39. Tick the correct option. Number 1. Rita dash feeling unwell. So, we have two options, that is are or is. So, let us find out Rita. Rita is singular or plural? Rita is singular, one person. So, we need to write is. If it is Rita and Rina, then you would write are. So, here it is singular noun. So, we need to use the auxiliary verb is. Rita is feeling unwell. So, this is the correct option. Next, we have my parents dash going to the market later today. Here, you have little confusion, that is, you need to know the tense. My parents, these are plural. Plural, we can use are and where. But you see, going to the market later today. So, these are present continuous tense. So, present continuous tense, we need to use are. Okay, auxiliary verbs, we need to see the tense. If it would have been yesterday, yesterday, the word you must have seen yesterday, then you will write my parents were going to the market later yesterday. So, here you see the present continuous tense. So, you can see today. So, we are writing my parents are going to the market later today. Third example, the teacher has or have checked the test papers. Let us see the example, the teacher. Teacher is singular or plural? Teacher is the word singular. With the singular, you have to use has. If it would have been teachers, then what you have to use? You have to use have. If it is teachers, then you will use have. If it is teacher, then you have to use has. Same way, here are, here it is has. So, understood? Have you understood, children? So, now next list of the exercise related to auxiliary verbs, you will do it yourself. Now, you have in your grammar book, page 40, exercise C. T for transitive, IT for intransitive verb. So, this one example I will tell you. The boy shouts. The boy shouts. Boy is the noun. What is the action here? Verb is shouts. So, here this is called, there is no object. So, you have to write intransitive verb. So, this particular exercise, you have all intransitive verbs. All 1 to 10 is, what verb it is? Intransitive verb. You can write intransitive verb. Now, next exercise we have, exercise D. Add a complement. So, that also we had gone through. Add a complement. Gaurav reads. Gaurav reads. It is not the full sentence. You need to write a complement, that is a book every night. The same way, the students tell stories to each other. So, you have this exercise in your page 40D. You can do it yourself, but I will also send the answers and you can write it with your pencil so that if your sentence is not correct, if you are not adding correct complement to the verb, you can change it. Okay, children? So, I hope you have understood everything. Everything is clear to you. Okay? Thank you.